presented Belgium. This is not the first film we've had from Belgium in Midnight Madness. Many of you might remember a film called Man Bites Dog. Well, now we have Whelp, or Cub. And what makes this one different is this is the very first film in Midnight Madness in the Flemish language. So let's hear it for the Flemish language! Now, let's just talk about childhood. Was anyone in here a Cub Scout? Show of hands. Was anyone a beaver, a brownie, a girl guide? Was anyone a member of 4-H? You go to summer camp. There are stories told around the campfire, and they're always meant to scare the bejeebus out of you and somehow put you to sleep quicker. No. Well, you're going to be told one of these campfire stories tonight, and it's by a very impressive first-time director. I want to introduce you. You're the first audience to see this film. I want to introduce you, all the way from Belgium, Jonas Govaerts.
This is very exciting. Like Colin said, I'm from Belgium. We have beer, we have chocolate, and we have child killers there. So that's what we're famous for. And Norma, up until 8 weeks ago, this film was going to premiere in Belgium. My dad was supposed to sit here, my mom over there, my best friend there, and then the rest would be filled up with child killers or something. But then we got a call from this wonderful man that the film is selected for Midnight Madness. And I don't know what that means. It's like you go mad until midnight. Like you wake up today and then you go mad because this is insane. So yeah. This is wonderful. This is way more than I expected. For a premiere, I couldn't dream bigger. So thank you, Bob. Thank you so much. And yeah, just a word of warning, there's one scene in here, we've test screened the film, some people have gotten very angry at me. If you're an animal lover, you might, have some questions for me at the Q&A. I'm more of a cat person, that's all I'm gonna say.
Just keep on repeating, it's only a movie, it's only a movie.
And no children or animals were insulted, but they weren't talking. Thank you, everybody, and enjoy the film. And of course, we will be back for Q&A.
Well, actually, Benny can probably explain better what we did, because I think there's a mic. was the brains behind that operation. This movie was financed in a conventional way, you know, for Europe, the same system as in Canada. And we started a Facebook page like half a year before we started to shoot. And we felt like quickly a buzz about the movie. We had 2,000 likes on our page, and we said, like, you know, we want to do something with this. So we said, why not do a small crowdfunding campaign, but not say, like, okay, we have a couple of millions for the movie, give 20 euros. So we came up with the idea of not crowdfunding the movie, but crowdfunding the trap. So we started a campaign to raise 35,000 euros with solving the fire trap to the cost.
And the scouting community wasn't really happy with that slogan, but whatever, it worked. So.
Do we have any
questions from the audience?
Yes?
I just wonder about the process of finding the boy.
Yeah, when I was writing, I thought, why even write this? Because I'm never going to find a boy that's going to play this. And then I was randomly working with a friend of mine, a cameraman, and he just said, come on, look at this, I did a music video. He pressed play, it was a thing that hadn't been released, and up came like a young river Phoenix from Belgium or something. And my search was over, it was like, okay, here's our kid, if he can't act, I'll double myself or something. But he was completely professional, he was a gift from the movie god. So a round of applause for Maurice. Yeah, you seem to have a similar situation here again. You know where that is going. Oh yeah, that's when I was writing the film again, being in Google Mobile, because I wasn't just alone, I came up with the traps, he did most of the story, to be honest. But I only listened to Zombie, which is C4's fans, just that on repeat, because it's so Argento inspired. And then by the end of the process, I thought, well, this guy's on Facebook, let's just send him a mail. Usually I get no response back, but he was like, oh yeah, cool, I'll do something. So that was, and it's very interesting because I saw a guest like a week ago, and to compare the two scores, he was on a roll.
He did a score for guest, and it's very different sound.
Yeah, it's a completely different function, but it's him, you know it's him, so it's amazing to have two films out with the same guy, and you can see how versatile he is just by comparing the scores.
His band is a zombie, he's kind of the best he works on. Who else do we have? Yes, on the side here,
are there any death scenes in the film that didn't make the cut?
He killed the dog a few times because he was. No, actually, no. What you see is what you get in this case. Well, who needed to die?
I'm just curious as to the ways you could come up with different ways.
Oh, I see. Well, the little blonde boy, we showed him alive at the end, but he annoyed me a little bit, so. Yeah. His fate is open in the case. There are plenty more traps in that forest. Yes, sir.
For a genre is like one of the most popular genres, it's not really clean, like it's very popularized. It's really good and scary, it's very cheesy. What are some tips to the director that you have helped you as making the not cross over to cheese?
Thank you.
Really
I wonder where you're going with that one. Type and then gradually shifted to something far larger, the Swiss Way Romance is called here. I wanted to go from that movie to that movie. Somehow, clearly, it seems to have worked. That was my big gamble for myself. I don't know if I was. So it's pure luck, basically. Yeah.
Really good.
No, it's so gratifying to see all those traps and with the audience laughing at the right time. So thank you so much for doing that.
First time you saw it with an audience. So.
Yeah, we had like very serious test audiences who pointed out flaws in the story, but this is the kind of crowd I like.
What else do we have here? Yes, the center, yes.
I was curious more about the narrative, because there were a lot of loose ends at the end, like very little answered. What was the decision behind that?
Well, in the script, we went conventional. At first, you get a lot of backstory of Sam, you know what happened in his past, you know why the guy is doing what he does, like the killer. But then when you start seeing more horror films, you realize we don't know these things, and it's far more powerful, I think, to have the audience fill it in a little bit. So some people say Sam is acting out of self-defense, some say he's going to the dark side. I have my version of the story, but it's something that people are very sure of what they see. So that's what we try to do, to make it a bit ambiguous so it's more fun for an audience, basically.
Hey, I was just wondering how I get that Suspiria ringtone for that.
Yeah, you get sued by Goblin first, that's how you get it. And you change two or three notes and then so, yeah. If we all stay quiet, I think he'll go away.
What's that?
Yes.
This being your first feature, why go with a horror film?
Well, you've done a number of short films as well, which were all drawn based. Why did you go to go for a feature horror film?
This is my first love, basically. It's Evil Dead 2, and once you see that film, you know, it's not just a great film, but they had so much fun making it that I couldn't do anything else as a genre. I mean, it needed to be horror, and we did a lot of comedy, and so Evil Dead 2 is the thing for a lot of things.
And yes?
Can you tell us about the inspiration for, like, the mask and who designed it?
Oh yeah, one of the hardest things to do is to find like an original horror mask because there's a lot of crap masks out there. So we decided to keep it simple, like I did in Halloween. Basically thought, okay, this is a kid who lives in the forest. He'd probably find like a piece of bark and modify it a little bit. And I have a friend who's a bit of a witch. She's an artist called Fia Silo, a white witch. She's a good witch. She came up with the initial design, and Saskia Bereich did all the special effects makeup. She modified it into this, and it's, I think it's beautiful, and then we use it as a poster as well, because it's so, I think it's very iconic. So yeah, it's just getting the right, the talented people together and hoping for the best, so thank you.
And the artist who did the poster is actually from Toronto based, and where's Justin?
Oh yeah,
we get good taste. And over here, on the side.
What are you working on next?
The sequel to this is
CUB 2!
Yes, this is going to respond, and it should be, well, people CUB 2, yeah, sure.
And we have this one more there, patient, yeah.
Actually, the animal, it's in a bag when it happens. I agree, it's still brutal.
You don't show the children?
No, actually, I made a decision right away. I thought we could take that one step and kill the children for a change, because that never happens in horror, so unless they're very evil. But I thought, let's be at least a little bit tasteful, so I never shot anything. I showed no blood there. I wanted to the impression of it, but not show that that would have gone too far for me as well. So we decided on the subtle thing of a truck going over.
And let's hear it for Kai!